Hello friends, my name is Dilip Pratap Singh Shekhawat. I've secured All India Rank 72 in Civil Service Examination 2018 and my optional subject was Public Administration. I'm here in front of you to discuss a detailed strategy regarding General Studies Paper 3 and I would like to give a tip initially that in my strategy I will cover following areas like book list, then approach and answer writing. But my tip to the candidates initially should be that when you are preparing for the General Studies Paper 3, you must ensure that you have to break the topics in this paper. There are five major topics in this covering economics, science and technology, environment and ecology, then security and disaster management. So my suggestion would be that you, when you are preparing for this paper, take it topic wise and prepare for a single topic specifically, and then you can organize this, combine these topics and prepare for the paper entirely when the examination is near you. So moving on, first and the most important thing from my side would be the book list, because you have to read less books, you have to read less sources and you have to ensure multiple revisions. That is very important. So I will bring out a very specific book list. You don't need to go out from these sources which I mentioned, and those are the following. For the economy section, it is very important that you go through the budget, the economic survey of that year, and then you must read a very one basic book, that is NCERT of class 11th and 12th. That is very important. And when it comes to one advanced level book, I think Ramesh for Indian Economy is a good book. So you must restrict yourself to these sources, and adding to it, newspaper reading and current affairs are very important as far as economy is concerned. So as far as Indian economy is concerned, around 10 questions out of 20 are asked in this paper. So hence the sources are too long in this section, but you must ensure that you read these sources and revise them multiple times. Don't need to go outside of these sources. Now coming to the next topic, that is environment. Now environment is a topic in which you must ensure that you are good with the current affairs. They would not ask a question from the static portions much, but a good knowledge of current affairs will get you very good marks in this section. And in this environment section specifically, you must always be thorough with the UN conventions and the programs and policies of the government. If there is any issue happening related to pollution, biodiversity, environmental degradation, etc., water crisis, etc., you must ensure that you have good hold over these topics. So in this way, environment can be prepared. Third is science and technology. For science and technology, again, current affairs are very important. You must always have a good hold over the recent developments in science and technology, whether it be any development in the Indian Space Research Organization, that is ISRO, or any Department of Space, or any molecular biology kind of topic, or any of the other topics which are there in science and technology, be it robotics, nanotechnology, medical field, etc. So you must ensure that you are good with current affairs. A very good source of preparing science and technology is reading the Science Reporter magazine. I think it discusses the issues in a detailed manner. And also a good reading of the Hindu is very important, because the Hindu brings out all the latest development in science and technology. Also in the Sunday edition, there is a separate page for science and technology in the Hindu. So you can always go through it. It will be very, very helpful, because the questions are very, very dynamic and those are all related to current affairs, and it will be helpful while preparing for this section. Now, another very important topic is this is the security. And in security issues, you must ensure that all the major issues in the country, you must be very thorough with those issues, like terrorism, Naxalism, then drug trafficking, human trafficking, etc. So you must make very, very short and brief notes on these issues, that what are these issues, what is the definition, then how deep the problem is in India. For example, if we talk about Naxalism, you must be knowing how many states are covered, then what the government has done in the earlier period, then what are the loopholes and what is the way forward. So in this way, every issue related to Indian security is very important, and you can prepare in this manner. And also this is a portion in which current affairs dominates again, and if you are good with current affairs in this sector, you will do good in the examination. And the final topic in this General Studies paper is disaster management. And disaster management is a very important topic, in the sense that Nowadays, we are facing many disasters, like the cyclone recently happened, and many of the things which are happening worldwide. And as we know that global warming and climate change is a reality, this section becomes important. So in this section, I would suggest that you must be thorough with the UN conventions on disaster management, and also you must prepare some topics about climate change, etc. And any of the recent events happened, for example, in my year when I was writing the examination, Kerala floods was a big issue, and also a question was there in the General Studies paper 3. So it is very, very predictable. You always have to go through the current affairs very well, link the current affairs with the syllabus of disaster management. You'll always be able to find out that what questions can be expected, and if you practice around those questions, you will get very good marks in this paper. So in this way, I've discussed the book list and how to have a good limited approach while reading the books and revising multiple times. Now, the next thing which I would discuss is the approach to this paper. Now, as I mentioned earlier in the initial part of the video, that you must always have a segregated approach. But when you have a segregated approach, and when you have prepared those things very, very nicely, then you must be able to combine it all together and try to again co-link it with other topics and interlink it with the other general studies paper. For example, if there is any economic question, then you can always link it to sections from polity or sections from history, society, etc. So that will be very, very good when you're writing the answers, and that will form a good source of value addition. So in this way, you can write answers. And in this paper, one thing is very important, that when questions are asked from economy, science and ecology, environment or disaster management, or for that matter security, those are very specific questions most of the times. So when the questions are very specific, you have to change the approach. You don't have to write very specific and boring answers. You always have to ensure that you are writing in a multidimensional format, and you are having something from all the other papers as well, and you have to ensure that you cover as many points and as many dimensions as possible. So that is why in this paper, I would suggest, if you're writing in a paragraph form in other papers also, in this paper you can shift your focus, and you can use pointers, and you can write in a point format, and you can also use diagrams specifically in the sections related to science and ecology. You can draw diagrams, and also in the environment section you can draw diagrams. So in this way, it is very helpful. When you value add these things, it becomes very, very helpful when you writing the examination, which will help you gain an extra mark over other candidates. So this is very important. And while practicing, the third part I would discuss is answer writing. Now, when you write answers in the General Studies paper 3, you must always ensure that you have to write on a daily basis, as I mentioned in paper 2, because this again is a very important paper, and it is a very high scoring paper also. If you are very good with these topics, because these are very specific areas, and if you write good answers, there is less scope of any subjectivity. So this is a very important tip from my side, that when you are writing answers in this paper, you must ensure that your value addition is very, very important. You must draw diagrams, you must always mention any expert committee if it is there. You must always go to the constitution and derive any specific article if it is related to that topic. Then you must mention the government programs and policies also. That will also be a very good source of value addition. And always have some very, very good innovative models with you. For example, if a question on environmental degradation is asked, you must always have a very good model for yourself. You must try to innovate something new, so that when you're ending your answer, when you're writing your conclusion, it gives a very, very good impact to the examiner, impression to the examiner, that this candidate has discussed the issues in detail in a multidimensional format, but he is also coming out with solutions. So in these areas like disaster management, environmental degradation, etc., biodiversity loss, and economy issues, when you come out with these solutions, and specifically the innovative solutions apart from the government committees, etc., it will be very, very helpful while gaining extra marks in these questions. So in this way, answer writing must involve all these areas, like drawing diagrams, mentioning committee reports, giving solutions, etc., is very, very important. And you always have to write on a daily basis, and join a very good test series in this paper also. And when you're joining the GS test series, when you're writing the answers to General Studies paper 3, please ensure that you interlink it among different papers. you have a multidimensional approach, you have a thought in your mind that you have to score extra marks than other candidates. You don't have to be a technician when you're writing a science and ecology answer, or you have to be an environmentalist when you're writing an environment answer. You just have to be a commonsensical and aware citizen who knows different aspects and who is very, very aware of the practical conditions which are happening. So in this way, I think this approach will be beneficial for all those candidates who will be attempting this paper. And all the very best from my side. Thank you.
Don't forget to subscribe with us and press the bell icon to never miss the video on Chanakya IAS Academy.